Want to make something look bright? Let's start by turning the lights down. Yep, you heard me right. Let me show you how to make something look bright by building shadows and darkness. It may seem counterintuitive, but without the presence of shadows, it's difficult to make something look bright. Take this shot, for example. The hat is being hit by a bright light, but it's those very dark spots and shadows that amplified the brightness of the hat. Without the contrast, this shot would be flat, and it would just be a hat on the chair. This shot was kind of an accident. We were filming a bunch of B-roll inside of an old farmhouse turned into a museum. We were filming some old pictures on a piano just to the left here, and I just noticed the sunlight coming in through the window. I quickly took this picture. The light wasn't quite there yet, but you could tell that in a few minutes, this beautiful, strong daylight would come right through the house. I knew we didn't have a lot of time, so we just pivoted the camera. I don't actually think we moved. And we exposed for the bright daylight coming in, and that created those very dark areas and big shadows. I used an old chair to hang the hat, and that made it possible to move the hat exactly where I wanted it, with just part of the hat hit by the light. If the entire hat was flooded by the light, again, it would have made that image very flat. But because only the bottom of the hat is hit by the light, the rest is much darker, amplifying the sense of brightness. Even the orientation of the hat was set to create those shadows that you see here and here. The same with the old clock and the couch. We wanted the light to only hit those few areas to highlight them. There are only two things that you can do to make something brighter. First, you need to expose your highlight as high as possible. So I wanted the tip of the hat to peak or be right below clipping. You can't make it any brighter than this. Adding more lights or exposing brighter won't do anything. It's already pure white. In this case, I actually like the fact that the tip of the hat is clipping. This is the shot straight out of the camera with the Rec 709 LUT applied to it. You can see on the waveform monitor that this section of the hat is clipping. So this is as bright as we can make it. But look how much darker the rest of the hat is. If we use the EL zone system, we can see that the bright spot on the hat is 6 stops above middle gray, and the rest of the hat quickly drops to 4 stops below middle gray. The second step, and really the only way to make things look brighter, is to bring down our midtones and shadows. So you can add negative fill everywhere to make sure that the background doesn't get any more light. You can close all the doors, you can block all the windows to prevent any light from coming in. Going back to the waveform of the original shot, you can see that we are right at the edge of crushing the blacks. Once you have those ratios, in post-production, you can take it a few steps further and really make this look brighter, again by lowering our shadows and midtone. Look how much the hat has become more and more the focus of the image as I bring down the levels. If we compare the waveform from the original shot and the graded shot, we can see that we didn't make the hat brighter. Again, pure white is pure white. We can't make it brighter than that. But by lowering everything else, the hat appears bright because the shadows are deeper. Now, we were at the right place at the right time, but we also understood that we needed to shape the shadows by placing the hat in the right spot, exposing for the highlights, and bringing our midtones and shadows as low as possible. So next time you want to highlight something, don't bring more light. Just shape your shadows, create darkness, and watch your subject become brighter and brighter. Now, thank you for watching this video until the end. As a token of my appreciation, I'd like to offer you my free camera setting cheat sheet. Just follow the link below to download the free cheat sheet. Thanks again, and happy filming.